Hello, my name is Ben Cantrell. I'm a senior music education major here at Baylor, and I play violin in the Baylor Symphony. In the aria and classic style, we feature our harp soloist, Claire Learned. This is a piece written by Marcel Grandjany, a French-American harpist and composer who founded the American Harp Society. This concertant style piece was born out of Grandjany's deep confliction over the events of World War I. It wasn't published until 1944, after World War II, but within it there is an immense amount of peace and reassurance in its delicate styling.
Thank you.
Thomas Canning was a 20th century American composer who had a prominent career in Canada and New England. In 1944, he wrote this Fantasy on a Hymn Tune by Justin Morgan. It's a work of sentimental Americana, depicting Canning's deep affection for the American landscape and for his parents. This piece is written for a double string quartet and string orchestra. The double string quartet parts are played by the violinists Helena Bandy, who plays a cadenza, Emily Bustos, Savannah Bowser, and Chris Bowser. The violists Grace Remmer and Brenden Guillory. The cellists are Kyle Monk and Aidan Gettemy, who also has a cadenza.
Thank you. as this is the final concert of this very strange year, we come to a bittersweet moment as we say goodbye to a number of folks for whom this is their last Baylor Symphony Orchestra concert. They have made significant contributions to the BSO and indeed to the entire School of Music, and we will deeply miss each of them. We are honoring our graduating string players at this moment, but we also are so appreciative of those winds and percussion graduates who played with the BSO in previous years. They will be recognized on our social media pages, and I thank Amy Nguyen for her leadership in that regard. Amy, thank you so much. As I call their names, I would ask them to join me here as Ben Cantrell, our musical host for this evening, tells us what their plans are going forward. Please hold your applause until they have all been introduced, and we're going to go by section. Violins, Helena Bandy.
Helena will be graduating with a master's degree in music performance in May and will continue to perform, teach, and freelance in Waco while taking orchestral auditions for the next year.
I think you can read.
Sure.
Chris Bowser.
Chris will be graduating with a bachelor's in science in mechanical engineering and a secondary major in violin performance. Following graduation, Chris hopes to continue pursuing solo and ensemble performances while attaining experience and pursuing jobs in the field of design and engineering.
Savannah Bowser.
Savannah will be graduating with a Master of Music in Violin Performance this spring and moving to Madison, Wisconsin to start building her private violin studio and auditioning for orchestras as auditions open back up.
Emily Bustos.
Emily will be graduating this May with a bachelor's in violin performance. She plans on returning to Baylor in the fall to pursue a master's in both violin performance and music theory.
Catherine Kim.
Catherine is graduating with a bachelor of science in chemistry and a secondary violin performance degree. She has been accepted to the DDS program at the University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston School of Dentistry, where she will begin this fall.
Catherine Pivaliza.
Catherine will graduate this summer with a Bachelor of Science degree in biology and a secondary violin performance degree. After graduation, Catherine will take a gap year before pursuing an MD to focus on medical research in the emergency department and medical scribing.
In the viola section, Brenden Guillory.
Brenden is planning on taking a gap year to practice for graduate auditions.
As Brendan's coming up, let's introduce Dylan Haynes.
After graduation, Dylan plans on taking a gap year in his studies to better develop an audition for graduate school. During that preparation, he will also be marrying the love of his life and moving briefly to Killeen, where she has recently found work.
Julianne Smith.
Julianne will be graduating in May and plans to return to New Jersey to teach elementary general music. She's currently in the process of applying for jobs and will hopefully be hired somewhere for the 21-22 school year.
And maybe we need to move this way just a little bit because we're running a little short on space. That's bad news for me. I don't want this many people graduating. Grace Remmer.
Grace is graduating with a Bachelor of Arts as a university scholar. She's grateful for all the years she has had with this beloved orchestra. She will miss you all while she's earning her master's degree in performance at the University of Texas, North Texas in the fall.
In the cello section, Aidan Gettemy.
Aidan is graduating with honors this spring with a Bachelor of Music degree in cello performance and a secondary major in mathematics. He'll return home to Katy to apply for graduate programs in data science and applied mathematics while continuing to practice, play, create musical projects with, and hopefully teach the cello. He writes that he wants to thank everyone in the Baylor Symphony Orchestra, and especially Mr. Heyde, for the most important music making of his life so far.
And finally, in the bass section, Garrett Mueller.
Garrett is getting married at the end of May and moving to Fort Worth to pursue a calling in youth and worship ministry.
And Donovan Goins, also in the bass section.
Donovan will graduate this summer with a Bachelor of Music degree and plans to look for studio orchestra openings in Austin and Los Angeles.
I am so appreciative of this wonderful group of people and musicians. I know they will have many spectacular successes in their endeavors in the coming year, and we certainly wish them all the very, very best. Will you join me, please, in thanking them?
This school year, the Baylor Symphony has made it its mission to excavate musical gems by neglected minority composers from the past. We present to you one such discovery, the Four Novelletten of Samuel Coleridge-Taylor. Coleridge-Taylor was an Anglo-African composer of great renown during the turn of this century. His mother was English and his father was African, and his early musical proclivities would be cultivated into international stardom by the age of 22 because his music displayed a novel harmonic palette, lots of character and sentimentality, and charming, catchy melodies. An innate warmth and sincerity shines through all of his work, and it's quite a shame that he would die young at the age of 37 in 1912. The first movement is an A major and marked Allegro moderato. It sets the climate and the attitude for the work as a whole and introduces us to the prominent roles of the tambourine and the triangle. The second movement is a playful sostenuto in C major. It's very coy. It starts off with muted strings and pizzicato and a wonderfully delicious melody from the violins. The third movement is marked Valse, but it is not a waltz that we would typically dance to. It is an A minor. It is doleful and displays quite a bit of anguish. It features a violin solo played by our wonderful concertmaster, Savannah Bowser. The final movement reveals the composer's hearth. It's a particularly British and exciting finale that closes the set of four pieces splendidly. We sincerely hope you enjoy this performance, and together we restore the rightful place that Samuel Coleridge-Taylor has in our concert halls.